are. Very fun, but very dangerous. Just like
some of the other marvelous adventures we've shared.
Mm-hmm.
Oh well.
That's the life we live. What a life it is. So much has taken place since my days as a young, timid boy, rushing about Sir Ector's castle, trying to get my chores done, always hoping he'd give me a chance to become K-Squire. That's all I really dreamed about in those days. I never would have imagined I'd be sitting here with all of you as your king. Never would have believed back then that I'd call beautiful Camelot in the city of bloggers the kingdom of bloggers my home, and the lovely Guinevere my queen. Never would have pictured that I'd have 150 of the bravest knights gathered here by my side. After you were all chosen to be a part of my knights of the round table, we were told to love one another and hold each other dear as brothers. From the love and sweetness that this hill brings, where you are all seated, will be born a beautiful friendship that you would be willing to lead your wives and your children to be with one another and spend your entire youth fighting side by side and enjoying adventures. Definitely never saw that in my future. However, there was always one that did. My advisor, an old friend, Merlin. He always said I'd bring hope to people in these dark times, though I never believed him. I wonder what the old wizard is up to now. Come to think of it, he did make my childhood one crazy adventure after another, with all the ways he tried to educate me. I remember it like it was yesterday. Whistling all the little rhymes he taught me. I still can't get them out of my head some days. All the studying he told me to do seemed pointless. However, Merlin had never shared me wrong in the past. Merlin did not support my dream of becoming a knight, because he said it was the brain that counted, not the brawn. A chivalrous one. He said true chivalry in honor did not exist among men in these dark times. He said that people needed hope. And Merlin had always been a great mentor to me. And for this reason, I kept studying. Why, it was he who advised me to use this round table as a sign of our times, to show equality to all, no matter their status. He sure had many interesting ways he tried to teach his lessons to me in the past. Physics, for example. Where is that book? Pitch Heaven. Ah, here it is. I remember this lesson. How could I forget? Merlin took me to a pond and used fish to teach me about forward and backward motion. Or that time he introduced me to the tyrannical king to prove his point on how might is not always right. And a true leader is weighed down by many things. I always thought, was I not weighed down by the life I was living? The endless chores? I never would have imagined I'd have used some of these lessons of leadership and kingly know-how, for who was I? I thought of myself as a nobody. All I could really think of becoming was K-Squire. Sir Ector told me, if I did well enough of my chores, I could have a chance to acquire this position. So I was eager to attend them. Dishes, feeding the dogs, cleaning, anything I was asked to do, really. Squire, was one step closer to a knight. Though I could never dream of becoming a real knight. For no one, I myself, knew my royal heritage at this time. Everyone said I was worthless and not fit to be trusted with anything the way I daydream, or go off on silly adventures with Merlin. However, hearing all these comments made me want to study and do what Merlin says, because after all, he had a plan for me. At the time, I was studying birds, wind, air pressure, thrust, how you don't fight the wind, but let it lift you. I suppose you could apply it to any part of life. However, back then I thought very different. I thought my fight was already chosen for me. A simple chore boy with no purpose, an orphan. All I could ever hope to become was K-Squire. As I'm sure you can tell by now, I had much self-conflict between what I wanted for myself and what Merlin wanted for me. Eventually, I became K-Squire by mere luck, for his last had fallen gravely ill after the last tournament they had attended. I was overjoyed, and it was at this time Sir Ector received a letter saying that the
top of stone in a church courtyard, and it is Merlin who is rumored to have placed it there to ensure that the proper king would come to rule over Great Britain. I was unaware of this tragedy and prophecy when we set out for London, which is where the sword was laid, for Kay's next tournament. I was in charge of bringing his equipment, and being so excited, foolish me, forgot his sword. Panicked and afraid of what he might do to me, and not wanting to rack up any more demerits, I set out to find him a new sword at once. I'm sure you all know the story from this point on. I find the magical sword in the stone, and unaware of how it will change my future, or what it will grant me, pull it and take my rightful place as your king. Now I am sorry if I have rambled on. I did not summon you all here to talk about my past, no, no. For I have something much better in store for us today. I think it is appropriate to address what happened to us all last night. The vision we all received of the Holy Grail. None of you should feel ashamed, for who would not feel stuttered after something like that? Filled the room with delicious odors and sights and left us feeling famished and full of hunger. We all had eaten and drank more than ever before that night. This vision we have shared cannot be ignored or forgotten. For I believe we have been shown this for a reason, so that we may embark on our next quest, our search for the Holy Grail. The legend of the Grail is most enduring. It is said to be the cup of the Last Supper and of the crucifixion, and held the very blood that flowed from Jesus' side. Legends say it is hidden in a mysterious castle, surrounded by wasteland, and is guarded by the Fisher King. Legends say he is already wounded, and his wounds fester and will not heal. His kingdom is doomed to share his sufferings. It was last known to be brought to Great Britain by Joseph of Arimathea, where it has laid ever since. Legends say, whomever drinks from this grail benefits from its magic. So I believe this is where our journey begins. This will take courage and strength, for we will not rest or turn to Camelot, those in our grasp. Can I get a huzzah? Very good. Then it is set. Tomorrow, we embark on our quest for king and country. Huzzah!